Hello everyone, my name is Daniel Castro, and today I'll be presenting SPHT, Scalable Persistent Hardware Transactions. This is a joint work with Alexandre Baldassin, Paulo Romano, and João Barreto. And let's start. Multithreaded applications that access shared resources are challenging to program. Ad hoc synchronization mechanisms are easily intertwined with application logic, and it is more code that programmers have to maintain. The same applies to durability. In databases, transactions provide durability. However, transactional memories traditionally work with volatile transactions. Some authors extended transactional memory with durability capabilities, aiming to simplify programming. I will call these systems persistent transactional memories, PTMs for short. Current technological trends forced PTMs to combine novel byte addressable persistent memories and HTM implementations of transactional memory. Such PTMs aim to overcome the performance limitation of their predecessors. However, combining these two novel technologies is far from being trivial, as I'll show you in the next slides. In hardware transactional memory, HTM for short, concurrent accesses to shared locations are handled by hardware mechanisms. Take as an example two transactions in different threads that try to access the same shared location. The hardware-level conflict detection will resolve the conflict by means of aborting one of these transactions. Byte-addressable persistent memories, PMs for short, is a novel technology that promises both faster durability than lock-addressable disks and higher capacity than DRAMs. Solutions for systems equipped with HTM and PM still have to overcome the issues related with volatile memories that stand in between CPU and PM, namely the CPU caches. Thus, it is necessary to explicitly manipulate them via flush instructions. A major limitation in designing HTM plus PM systems following a standard write-ahead logging approach is the fact that if an HTM transaction tries to flush data from the CPU caches while inside the HTM context, the transaction deterministically aborts. Existing solutions like DUTM, CCHTM, and VHTM solve this problem using a shadow memory approach, whereas Crafty uses a non-destructive undo log approach. In this presentation, I will focus on shadow memory solutions, and you can find a broader analysis in the paper. In the shadow memory approach, HTM transactions access a volatile partial copy of the persistent heap. HTM transactions execute on top of volatile DRAM and generate logs in PM that contain all the modifications done to the shared state. These logs are later replayed by the log replayer, which applies the modifications in the correct order to the persistent heap. Finally, upon recovery, the persistent heap is mapped in DRAM using, for example, the copy-on-write mechanism. This is the approach followed by our novel proposal, SPHT. HTM, and TM in general, adhere to strong consistency models. We advocate that the durability model for PTMs should follow similar criteria to the one found in the database management systems. SPHT adheres to the immediate durability criteria, which enforces that any transaction that returns to the application is guaranteed to be durable. In this example, I show a transaction T that becomes durable just before returning to the application. This durability model also enforces that all the preceding transactions that T may depend upon must be durable at the moment of returning to the application. This avoids inconsistency issues that arise from inter-transaction dependencies. There are already a few works that combine HTM and PM. However, they suffer severe limitations. As for transaction processing, some state-of-the-art solutions use global logical clocks that need to be incremented whenever an update transaction commits, leading to spurious aborts. Some other solutions follow a design that extend the logical boundaries of an HTM transaction, making transactions prone to conflicts. A third issue, as we'll see more in detail further in this presentation, is the inclusion of a sequential mechanism in the critical path of execution aimed at ensuring transactions' immediate durability, which can easily become a system's bottleneck. As for the replay, most existing solutions rely on sequential approaches, making poor use of the abundance of hardware resources available on modern machines. Those resources could instead be leveraged to reduce the recovery costs with direct benefits on the system's availability. Relaxed models allow transactions to not be immediately durable, but they are at odds with the common understood semantics of transactions. SPHT solves all the mentioned limitations, focusing on scalability without compromising the durability. This work evaluates SPHT and other 5 solutions for H10+ PM in commodity hardware. It's worth noting that, to the best of our knowledge, all the previous works emulate PM. Our main contributions with SPHT are: first, a novel commit logic that scales without compromising durability, and second, a set of novel log replay techniques aimed at improving the availability of the system. Let's focus now on NVHTM. This solution design is similar to our SPHT system. However, NVHTM incurs in a bottleneck in order to satisfy immediate durability that I will illustrate in this slide. Assume 4 concurrent transactions. Each of them first executes in HTM and obtains a physical clock that serializes their position in the per-thread log. Then, each flushes their logs, but the final commit marker that will tell the log replayer that the log transaction is ready to be replayed. In this example, T0 can flush its own local marker, as it does not depend on any other transaction. However, T1, T2, and T3 may depend on T0. This is because they have a larger timestamp than T0, and for that reason they may depend on T0. Thus, they must wait T0 to be ready for replay before flushing their commit marker. While the transaction with a smaller clock does not complete flushing the commit marker, the other transactions with a larger clock cannot proceed with the flush of their own commit marker. Thus, NVHTM design incurs in increasingly larger waiting times as more concurrent transactions try to commit. SPHT's design is based on the observation that a tight thread count, a large number of transactions, is likely to be concurrently trying to commit. The key insight is that if the pending transactions were able to observe their mutual state, then, in this example, T3, because it is the transaction with the highest physical clock, could update a global commit marker in PM that represents the set of transactions since the moment of T0 until T3. More in detail, T3 obtains the physical timestamp 115, flushes its log, manages to update the persistent global marker, and then it flushes it to PM. The transaction log of T3 is only ready for replay when the global marker contains a value larger or equal to 115. The other two transactions, T0 and T1, detect that T3 is updating the global marker, and they delegate the task of updating the global marker to T3. Because the global marker will be updated with a value larger or equal to the clocks of T0 and T1, which are respectively 100 and 105, they can safely ignore updating it. T2 concurrently tries to update the global marker, but in this example the comparent swap fails for T2 and succeeds for T3. Thus, only T3 updates the global marker. Because the timestamp of T3 is larger or equal to the timestamp of T2, T2 can also safely delegate the task of updating the global marker to T3, as T0 and T1 did. In the paper, you can find the detailed pseudocode and correctness arguments. The log replayer process is crucial to prune the logs and release space for other transactions to execute, and for the availability of the system. In the paper, we present a set of techniques aimed at extracting the most performance out of the log replayer, namely using a parallel log replay, using nonaware schemes, and exploiting flush instructions like write back and invalidate cache. I will explain more in detail the linked log approach to reduce the log replayer processing effort. This paper presents a base variant of SPHT and another 2 variants that link the logs. In the base one, transactions do not provide hints of the next or the previous transaction, whereas the variants that leave hints do so by means of exploiting the commit logic that already exists in the base solution. Thus, SPHT pinpoints either the previous or the next transaction with a relatively low cost during transaction processing. It is worth noting that this mechanism will save cycles during the log replay. We evaluate SPHT with and without linked log and other 5 solutions in a system equipped with an HTM-enabled CPU and 512 GB of PM. The SPHT source code and benchmarks are available in the link below. For fairness, all designs are implemented in a common framework. All of them provide immediate durability, which were implemented using the indications in the respective papers. STEMP is composed by various benchmarks. Here I will present Vacation, and in the next slide you will also see Genom. The Vacation benchmark implements an online transaction processing system that emulates a travel reservation system. The graph shows the throughput obtained by executing this benchmark for a given number of concurrent threads. Vacation Low is a scalable workload for HGM transactions, and in this scenario, SPHT can scale up to 64 threads. Whereas other solutions hit a bottleneck around 1.5 million transactions per second. It's worth noting that SPHT has a throughput 2.6 times larger than NBHTM at 64 threads. We collected the logs of Vacation and Genom, and we measured the throughput of the log replayer for a given number of concurrent threads. The curves labeled as sort use the log produced by the approach that does not leave hints in the log, whereas the link curves use the log produced by the linking approaches. In Genom, at 16 threads, we have gains of 2.1x using the linking approach, and in Vacation, the gains are 1.3x. I'll conclude this presentation with the key takeaways of this paper. Since the introduction of HTM and the proposal of novel PM techniques, many authors proposed systems that combine both HTM and PM. However, they have scalability limitations, as I have shown you. SPHT improves the state of the art by using a novel group commit approach that aims at scalability without compromising the durability. This PHT can have gains of up to 2.6x versus the state-of-the-art solutions at transaction processing. And I have also shown you that the log replayer improvements, exploiting the system resources and log hints, can significantly increase the recover performance. To finish, I would like to thank the other co-authors of the paper, Alexandre Baldassin, Paulo Romano and João Barreto. Thank you for listening. If you have any follow-up questions, please send them to the email below.